Welcome to your electronic chain of custody. Learn the basic steps to creating your chain of custody using eCOC. The first step is to locate the QR code, which is on your bottle order paperwork. The next step is to scan the QR code with your mobile device. You'll be taken to a login screen here, where you'll want to enter your email and password, or you'll want to register as a new user if you don't have an account. Once you log in to EOL, you will be taken directly to the electronic chain of custody that is associated with the bottle order. And once you open up the electronic chain of custody, you're going to want to review all the sections. Up here, we have your client-specific and project-specific information. Down here are the sample names and IDs. Over here, we have the methods pre-populated and everything's checked. And over here, we have our containers already populated. You can edit any of these sections by clicking on the header, and you'll be taken to a screen where you can make changes to sample IDs, add a sample, make some changes to the methods, containers, et cetera. When you're ready to start sampling, you'll want to click on the sample you're going to start with, and you'll be taken to the sample screen. You can also make edits on this screen. For example, here, you could change the sample name. When you're ready to collect, you go over to the orange button, hit collect now, and your date and time will be stamped right here on the electronic chain of custody. If you want to collect field data, down here under field data, you can add your pH reading. If you want to add additional field data parameters, you can collect field data manager and add them. We also have some optional fields here, and you'll notice all these fields are collapsible. That's to give you more space on your mobile device. You're able to record the longitude and latitude if you want, a place to note any potential hazards, some check boxes, if this is field filtered, if this is QC for MS-MSD, or this analysis is on hold. And you also have a location to put some comments that you want to communicate to the laboratory. Down further, you can review the methods again and the containers, and you're able to make some changes if you need to make them here. When you're done with your first sample, you can hit next, and we'll take you to the next sample. And hit collect now, record some field data, and hit next, and it'll take us through the samples. I'm going to collect the third sample in this example. I'm going to put in a pH. I'm going to hit next. I'm going to go to my last sample, hit collect now, and then I'm going to hit done because I'm done collecting, which will take me back to the front page. You'll see now that we have our dates and times populated on the eCOC. So now you want to review the electronic chain of custody at one more time to make sure that the sample IDs and the methods and the containers are correct. Once you've confirmed that everything is as you want it to be, you have the opportunity to go into the cooler section here and add information about a cooler. You can hit new to add a cooler. And you can put a description of your cooler here. I'm going to call this one large blue. The next field is a QR barcode field where we can enter information so that the laboratory will be able to identify the cooler that arrives with this electronic chain of custody. You can put a QR code or barcode label on the outside of the cooler, and you can hit scan right here to scan that label within eCOC, and it will associate this eCOC with that cooler. You can also type in a unique identifier here, like Alpha 1. Name the cooler, mark the cooler somewhere, Alpha 1, and the laboratory will be able to associate them that way as well. We also have a field here for a tracking number. If you're sending your samples in via FedEx, UPS, or an outside courier, and you have a tracking number, you can type that in here so the laboratory can also have another means to reference that cooler with the electronic chain of custody. When you're done with your coolers, you can hit done. Then you'll hit done a second time, and we're taken back to the front page of the electronic chain of custody, and you'll see down here we have coolers included on the front page. The next step is to sign and submit your chain of custody to the laboratory. This is an electronic submission. It's going to send this completed chain to the laboratory, and it will be available for them to pre-log in the samples if they want to do that. So you'll hit sign and submit this green button up here in the top right. And you'll get a little warning letting you know that once you submit, you're going to need to roll back the submission to make changes to the chain. You're able to edit once you hit submit up until the point of physically relinquishing the samples. And down here under the custody field, you'll see that it's noted that the custody, this chain has been submitted. The next step will be to physically relinquish the samples to the laboratory. So after submitting, when you're ready to physically relinquish the samples, there's a blue button up here in the upper right-hand corner, and you'll click relinquish. and a pop-up window will pop up. And there are two options here. You can confirm the relinquish to an accepting party, that would be in person in one of our locations, or you can relinquish to a secure location if you're leaving these samples in a drop box or you are dropping these off with FedEx or an outside courier, that would be a relinquish to a secure location. For this example, I'm going to hit confirm relinquish to an accepting party as if I'm in one of our locations. And this will be on your mobile device, and you'll want to show this mobile, the QR code on your mobile device to the person in the location where you're dropping off the samples, and they will scan this on their end and do the accepting of the samples. So when you hit close, and down here on the custody, once that you'll see that it added relinquished by down here at the bottom under the custody section. After physically relinquishing the samples, the laboratory will proceed to log in the samples, and you will receive an email that your submission and relinquishing was accepted by the laboratory.